Hi students, today we discuss some other topic for English for Common Examination. For third week is department students, unit 1, second topic already. In last class we see about nouns. Today we discuss some other topic for pronouns. First you know about the definition of pronoun. Pronoun is based upon noun because noun is also based upon what the naming was used in naming was. In noun also using place, things, person, name. In same way, in pronoun also some points will be changed in pronouns. A verb used in the place of a noun or instead of a noun is called pronoun. Same where you are using the noun was the same places you use the noun pronoun also. For example, what other pronoun words means? He, him, his, her, she, it, you, yourself, they, them, they all, themselves. These are not pronoun words. In noun words we are using names only, but in pronouns we are using when you say some gents name is they use it only he. In that places you did not use name for functions. Now a pronoun can also be used to act as a subject or the object of the verb in a sentence. In same way in noun also you use the noun words in subject and then object and then complement. The same way in pronoun also you are using the words pronoun words in subject or objects or it based comes with the verb because this pronoun is based upon this verb.
Thank you.
Brahman. This demonstrative pronouns is points of the objects of persons. For definition, pronoun that points out an object, a person or persons is called a demonstrative pronoun. When we find out in the objects, you see the person name is in that places, you have to use the demonstrative pronoun. For example, this, that, these, and those. This is my school teacher. Already we saw this, that, these, and those. For this verse, I use some sentence. This is my school friend. When we compare to other persons, you say he is my school friend, but that is the personal using the sentence in personal pronoun. But here, when you find out the sum of persons means you are using this. This is my school friend. When you introduce others means in that time you are using this sentence. That is my elder sister. When we introduce to others means that time you are using these sentences. Those are my classmates. When you introduce yourself for others and then your friends and all, we are using demonstrative pronoun. Next one is reflexive pronoun. A pronoun which is used as the object of the verb in your sentence. In this reflexive pronoun, it is used only in object, but in personal pronoun, it is used in subject. Demonstrative pronoun also uses this word only in subject. This reflexive pronoun is used only in the sentence or end of the sentence, object only. For himself, herself, yourself, myself, themselves, and ourselves. This is under reflexive pronoun verbs. These verbs always using at the end of the sentence, object only. Example, Aravind killed himself. He killed himself only. And then they painted their houses themselves. When we say Aravind killed himself, this is singular. And then they painted their house themselves means so many members are painter. And then we blamed ourselves. Somebody else blamed ourselves only or some others. I caused myself. This is a not reflexive. Next one is fourth one, possessive pronouns. Already we thought about what is my personal pronouns and then what is my demonstrative pronoun, what is my reflexive pronoun. Now we discuss about possessive pronouns. You also know what is meant by possessive. The possessive pronouns are used to show that something belongs to somebody. Always possessive pronoun. You love somebody else, means you have some possessiveness to that person. So that's why only you are also say the same thing. It belongs to somebody else. For example, singular and then plural form. For first person, let me say it is mine. This is mine. And then in plural form, you say this is under us. In second person, in singular and then plural, both of them using the same words, was and then was. But in first person, we have some changes. When we use my at the end of object means, in that cases when you use plural form, you say us. In third person, his, has, his. These words are used in the singular only using these words, but in plural, using theirs. So this way of possessive pronouns using in pronouns. Next one, relative pronoun. This relative pronoun is based upon demonstrative pronoun and then interrogative pronoun. Interrogative means it gives some questions. When we ask a question, start about WH questions or how. So this type of questions you are asking. So that is the interrogative pronoun for what, which, who, whose. This is under interrogative. the same way in relative pronouns using interrogative pronoun and demonstrative pronoun. These two functions will be action in relative pronouns. For example, this is the book that I bought last week. Here, that is referring to the demonstrative pronoun. This also, it is one of the word of demonstrative pronoun. Here, you join these two sentences. In this place, you are using the verbs for demonstrative pronoun verbs. This is the book that I bought last week. Already, I bought this book in last week itself. Second one, I love those who love me. Here, those is the demonstrative pronoun. So, next one, when we ask some questions means, what's your name? And then, where are you working? Who is your father? So, this way of questions asking in relative pronoun. When we ask some relative questions means, in this pronoun also say the same thing. But in this relative pronoun, you use the interrogative pronoun and demonstrative pronoun. But in this relative pronoun, you don't have separate nouns. Thank you.